Hello again, everybody. I'm back out at the tiny house again, and you can see behind me the bathroom. The bathroom is empty. I have taken everything out. There, well, you can't really see it. There is, which this bathroom is pretty small. Kind of hard to film in here. There we go. They're kind of up in the corner. No bathtub, and no toilet, no sink. Everything is out of here. The reason being in the tub, actually, one problem, the tub no longer fits through this door without taking the actual sliding door off. But I think I can work around it. I just got it stuffed over in here. It'll be fine. But what I'm going to do today here is I have some linoleum that I'm going to put down on the floor in the bathroom. Now, I don't think it's going to be very easy to film in that bathroom where it's so small. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put this in, and I'll catch back up with you after that. Because it will be really hard to film that. I'll be knocking the camera over and everything. I know I will. So, I'll get back to you in a few minutes and we'll see what all I did. Alright, so we have now got a linoleum floor in here. It looks a little better. I'd say I got to put some threshold stuff over that part. I'd say most of y'all have probably already spotted my mistake. I can see it plain as day now. I couldn't see it when I was cutting it, apparently. But if you notice the squares, they're not straight. But anyway, yeah, you can tell it's a little off. But I think this tile looks pretty good. I think this linoleum looks pretty good. I mean, it almost looks like real tile. And water is not going to hurt it. Now, one thing I have seen, which I know I did have a subscriber that said this stuff would not last. And you're right, it won't. A little bit of water got on that and there, everywhere it got on it, it shows. So, yeah, I think I'm going to end up having to redo this wall at some point. That's fine. You can tell I already have some water in here. There was never any leaks from the tub itself. Now, I am going to seal around the edges and stuff like that at some point. But for right now, I'm testing the drain itself. And it is holding, it seems. You can see I'm going to build a box around these, and I'm going to put the actual faucet like hanging over here a little bit. And I guess I'll probably run a copper line up for the shower. But for right now, that's not actually hot water. Even though the valve is red, that's not hot water, because the hot water, you can tell what I did here. This is the in for the water heater. That is the out for the water heater. And this is my water heater right now. Otherwise, I don't have a water heater for in here. I was going to use the one in the old house, but I found another one that's a little better that will allow me to adjust the temperature. It's got little push buttons on it that allows you to adjust the temperature. And it will maintain the temperature without you having to constantly adjust it up and down. And it doesn't have to be modified to be used inside. It's already made to be used inside. Now, the one in the house, I had to modify to make it safe for inside use. This one it has the sides all sealed up. And it has a chimney comes out of it. And you run the chimney up to wherever you want it to go. All right, so We just need a toilet and sink in here and some fixtures, and we'll be in business as far as the bathroom goes. Now, this is a little junky still, but we're working on it. Okay, in here, now I started trying to paint that foam stuff, and I'm not satisfied with the way it's looking. I think what I'm going to actually do is either get some caulking and put around. I mean, look at Lowe's. Actually, I think I'm about going to Lowe's here in a little bit to get a toilet, because we don't have a toilet for in there. But when I go to Lowe's to get the toilet, I'm going to look for some caulking to go around there. Last time that I looked, they didn't have any. And I tried to, I'm going to have to clean that up. Looks like it was on fire. That's because it was. I tried taking the torch and burning that foam, and it didn't work either. I'm going to actually mix up some cement or just use some of that caulking and put in here. But anyway, that's beside the point. Throw that in there. Point is, I want to make that look good, so probably some caulking that I can find that will be like a hard, like stove caulking or something like that. Now, one thing that we need to address in the living room, which will really kind of have, if you look around, one more step and it will have the living room finished, and that is the ceiling. You can tell there is a serious lack of ceiling, and that is not permanent. That fan is not. I'm actually going to have a ceiling fan in here instead of this, but that actually, when I was using the heater, that would blow all the warm air because it would go upstairs, so that would circulate the warm air down here. That's coming back out. But yeah, like I said, as you can see, besides the little bit around here and the ceiling and the fan, the living room would be done. That will have basically the downstairs. Once I get the toilet in there and the sink and everything, it'll have the downstairs mostly complete, and I can start working on the upstairs. I'm actually thinking about next week going ahead and picking up a couch to put right here, because this part is going to be done. I could actually have a couch sitting there and actually be able to like spend some time out here not just working. But anyway, yeah. So what we're going to do is we're going to try to do a ceiling. Now, this is not going to be your traditional ceiling. And I don't know how it's going to work. All right, so the other day, I went up and I just kind of took a little nap up there, and I was looking up at that ceiling up there, the foam that I had up. It's kind of close to the same color as my cabinets, and it really doesn't look that bad. And as far as that goes, I could paint it. Kind of a weird idea that I come up with. I don't know how it's going to work, but I'm going to try it. If nothing else, I can always cover it. I've got some stuff. I've got some of that insulation board, and I got some of these kind of boards. When I was doing it upstairs in the bedroom, my only intention was to put that up to have an extra insulation barrier. And I wasn't really like trying to make it all match up or look good or anything like that. This, what I want to do is I want to make the seams go over top of my floor joists, so that when I put the trim boards up, it'll go over the seams and you won't have any seams that you're going to see in here. I don't know how that's going to work or how it's going to look. Even if it doesn't work, all I've got to do is cover it sometime with something else. But anyway, I think I want to try this and just see how it works out. Let's just slap it up here and see what happens. Okay, well, I got a little bit done today. Probably won't be able to see this ceiling, but well, this part over here is not done yet. I still have to do a few more pieces across like that, but if you can see this part above me, I have put the blue insulation foam stuff up there, and we don't have any echo even though we are surrounded by wood, because I think that blue foam is actually absorbing the echo. It seems to be working. See if I can get a shot of it from here. You can kind of see the ceiling. I think it looks all right. I mean, if you didn't know that that was insulation foam, you'd think it was just either sheetrock or something like that that I had painted. But it's just an insulation foam, and it matches fairly close to the cabinets. So that works out. And then, let me swap you around here and show you the bathroom. All right, so in here we have, I couldn't resist, I had to go get a toilet. And, well, it is hooked up. I don't like the way that this is. I ran out of blue pipe, by the way. But I'm going to take this connector off and put a 90 and drop it down. That way it can come down through here and look a little better. But it's hooked in, but I'm not going to turn the water on yet, because you may notice on the bottom there are no bolts yet, because it did not come with them. It came with the caps to put over them and the little washers, but it did not come with bolts. I don't know why that was, or the wax ring that goes under it. So even if I did have some bolts, I still couldn't put it on there. Kind of disappointing, but at least we got some done today. I do have some threshold stuff. I didn't get to that today, though. But I got pretty much done today. You know, you can see I put trim around and behind the bathtub and all that, and up here, back there. This is going to be my sink, by the way. Or I need the toilet paper yet, because the toilet's not hooked up, but this is going to be my sink. I'm thinking maybe here, or maybe just in the top of the toilet. See, what I'm going to do, I'm going to plumb the sink into the top of the toilet so that as you wash your hands, the water runs down into the toilet. Now, I don't know if I'm just going to pretty much do a basic sink sticking up out of the toilet like that with a faucet coming up behind it, or if I'm going to mount it over here. I don't know really yet. It's all kind of, you know how I work. I never know what I'm going to do next either, so don't feel lonely. Anyway, I wish I had my water heater, because, of course, we do have water now, but it's cold on both sides. I've got it running through a water filter, and it should be nice to keep all this, the silt and stuff, out of our plumbing, because we have had trouble with that in the other house. Anyway, that's about all I got done today. I mean, it doesn't sound like much, but you can see that I trimmed out all of this. So it did take a fair bit of work, plus a trip to Lowe's and to pick up the toilet, which I should have checked out better. And once again, this light is not staying. This is a temporary light. The box there, you can tell, you know, that's not really the way you hook up a light by code and all that. This is just so that I've got light to work in here by. I'm putting a ceiling fan in there, which I don't have yet. But once I get that, that will complete the living room. Then we will actually be ready to start kind of moving stuff into the bottom part. Now, I still haven't done the top yet, but we'll get there. Now, I was, like I said before, I was trying to paint that, and actually now that it's dried, it looks a little better than what it did before, but what I have for that is some clay colored window, door, siding, and trim caulking. And this stuff should, I think it might work. I'm going to try it. I mean, they didn't have what I wanted. I wanted some stuff actually that's kind of designed for stoves that you can put around it. But they didn't have it. So I'm going to try this. I mean, all it really has to do is make it look good. So, you know. And also up here, I did put a little shelf that I may expand out a little more. I think their fridge is going to come out to about here. So I'll probably expand that shelf on out. Well, actually past where that trim comes to. I guess that's kind of why I left that sticking out. But I need to get the refrigerator first to see how far it comes out. Because I want it to match. I want it to come out and both of them be even. That way I can store stuff up there. It also covers up my stairwell. That was the main purpose of it. But anyway, I guess that was pretty good progress. But it is getting dark outside, as you can see. So I'm going to call it a day. I feel pretty good about what I've got done. And I think it may not be much longer. And we'll be moving in here. I'll be doing a moving day. But anyway, I appreciate everybody watching. And I'll see y'all on the next one.